All right, so you've got a really solid business idea, but you could use a little help getting it off the ground. Well, listen up. Shark Tank, you know that show. I love watching it. I binge watch it on ABC. Heck, I even watch the replays on CNBC because I'm that kind of guy. Ordinary entrepreneurs, they only get advice, but sometimes get some real serious financial backing from top investors, and they are having open auditions here in our fair city.
Not only that, it's happening right now, Sean. Folks, you can share your idea and get a shot at being on the show. Here is casting producer Mindy Zermack with more. How are you?
Good, thank you. Thank you for having me.
This is exciting. The auditions are happening right now.
They're happening right now at the Venetian in the Delfino Ballroom. This is our fourth time at CES, and if anyone wants to come down, they can come on down. We're handing out wristbands from 9 to 11. We will be handing out them a little bit after that as well. Interviews start at 10, and we'll be interviewing there all day long.
I'm curious to what the casting call is like for this, because we've all seen some of the casting calls for other reality shows, per se, and you're not going to walk in like William Hung doing bad singing. This is like, you actually have to have a business plan, have a product, have something to show, a little bit of a song and dance to sell it. What are you looking for?
We're looking for passionate entrepreneurs. Anyone who has a prototype or a business plan, or if they have a mom and pop that needs to get to the next step, if they're looking for an investment to get to the next step, Shark Tank is a great way to go. And so we want to see the passion come out today more than anything. Anything that's going to set them apart from other companies or products, we want to hear it. So passion and energy goes a long way, and knowing those numbers, because Mr. Wonderful will get you.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I know, right?
And he'll try to get you for 4% in perpetuity as well. Watch out for Mr. Wonderful, the sharkiest of the sharks. Yes, of course.
Speaking of those numbers, on a practical level, what should people bring down if they bring their idea today?
Sure, so we actually hand out paperwork when they arrive, so they don't need to worry about anything. They just show up, we give them a wristband, paperwork. If they have a demonstration that they want to show us on a computer or a physical demonstration or of their product, or they want us to have samples, we welcome all of that. That's really all they need. And then they'll pitch to us their 1-minute pitch. They don't have to have a pitch like they're on the show. We're a little kinder right now than the sharks.
These are not the sharks. Yes.
We won't bite.
The warm up.
These are the little guppy fish.
Exactly.
Just wait. Yes.
Exactly. And then we'll hear their pitch, ask a couple follow-up questions, and then that's it.
And if you're chosen, how does this all happen? You go to LA and magic happens?
Yeah, so this Vegas and CES is our very first open call of season 10, which we're very excited about.
Because there's a lot of entrepreneurs. It's not just the big companies at CES.
Exactly. We always go and look for the small ones because CES has a lot of those. So they can come to the open call. We're having more throughout the season. We'll be in Dallas in 2 weeks, and we're going to be announcing on ABC.com some more. They can also apply via website on ABC.com through email if they miss it, so don't worry. But they will go through many, many more rounds if they make it through the process, and season 10 will air this coming fall into next spring, and we film sometime in the summer, usually around June or September.
And frankly, even if you don't get the financial backing, you get on the show, your business goes through the roof. The Ice Age meals I got from Shark Tank. I got the slide belt. Actually, I forgot to wear my belt
today. Oh, yeah, you love the belt.
The mission belt, I believe. I got what else? I've gotten stuff from that Scrub Daddy. And no one picked up Scrub Daddy.
Scrub Daddy's huge.
And they all missed on it, and it's $1 billion company.
Scrub Daddy was invested by Lori Greer.
Oh, it wasn't? Oh, good.
Yes.
Lori's smart.
Yes, right, and he's one of our biggest success stories. I believe he's done over $175 million since he aired on the show.
What was the biggest past up one? There was one that got passed up.
I mean, we've had so many companies come through, and now in 10 seasons that I lose track because I've been on for 10 years. But there's a lot, I'm sure.
I'm a super fan. I've read the articles, the ones that they wish they went on. Yeah.
I want to ask Mindy.
Oh, it was Ring Video Doorbell.
Oh,
yes.
Was on?
Big money
it
lost.
Was on. I didn't know that. I have two of them. Oh, my gosh.
And he actually, his company is now valued at $1 billion. And Richard Branson actually invested, not through Shark Tank, but after the show.
It's so interesting, this show.
It's
exciting to have you here.
Thank you. We're very excited to be here. Would love to have everyone come down and give it a shot.
Let's invent something.
Better bands. Why don't you get down there?
It's too niche. That's what you tell me. Right. Kick me out.
We'll think of something.
Yeah. Okay.
Get your pitch ready, folks. Do you have one? Oh, head on down. Right now, the open casting call for Shark Tank is happening right now at the Delfino Ballroom inside the Venetian. Head down for your chance to be on Shark Tank.
And right now, speaking of